Good afternoon. I wanted to spend a few minutes and kind of share with you how to do Chapter 8 project and what it's all about. So this project is all about getting a bigger concept of what the purpose of Chapter 8 is. And the idea is that when you compare, let's say, two classes of statistics and their exam scores, within a class, you could have a lot of variation. Because you could have a student that scores really high and you could have a student that scores very low. But when you compare overall averages from class to class to class, the more classes that you have, the more similar they're going to be to each other on average. And so that's why we have to have this thing called a standard error, which is taking the standard deviation and dividing by the square root of n. And so this project is getting at that. So once you make a copy of the Google Doc, it's asking you to load the sampling distribution bell-shaped applet in StatCrunch. So in StatCrunch, you're going to go here to applets and scroll all the way down to the one called sampling distributions. And now in the project, it's first asking you to go to the bell-shaped one. So we're going to click on bell-shaped. And it says set the applet so that the population is bell-shaped, state the mean and standard deviation. So in here, it just says mean is 25. So just use the one that's there, that's fine, but make sure that you state what you have right here on your in your project. So there's that. And then you can see that the mean is 25 and the standard deviation is 5. So there's three sections here in the project. So the top one is the population. That's what you're writing on your project on the first line here. And then it says, obtain 1,000 random samples of size 5, size 10, size 20. So here you can see I'm going to change the middle one. I'm going to say sample size of 5. And then at the top of my screen, I have to scroll up. At the top, I'm going to hit 1,000 times. So when I do that, the very bottom says I did 1,000 samples of size 5. And the bottom one is the one that you're going to record, this mean and this standard deviation, okay? And then so I'm going to record that here in this column. Then I'm going to go and do the same thing with n equal 10. So I'm going to go back to StatCrunch and I'm going to say, okay, my sample size is now 10. I have to go back to the top and hit 1,000 times and then it will regenerate. And then you're going to copy down the mean, like I'm circling here, and standard deviation in your table. And then you're going to do that again for n equals 20. And then it's asking you to make some observations on part 1D and 1E. Then it says, now load the sampling distribution uniform applet. So you're going to go back to StatCrunch. And you're going to go to the applet, to the same applet, the sampling distributions. And you're going to click on the uniform, which is the top one, and hit compute. And then it's asking you to obtain 1,000 samples of size 2, 5, 10, 20, and 30. So similar to what we did before, you've got the sample size of 2, and you're going to hit that 1,000 times. Again, you're going to jot down what's in the very bottom box here in your table each time, 2, 5, 10, 20, 30. And then it's asking you to make some observations on parts 2D, 2E, and 2F. And then it's going to have you go through a third time. And this time you're going to choose the skewed one. So back here to StatCrunch. And you're choosing again the sampling applet. And you're going to choose right skewed and compute. And you're going to follow this and hit 1,000 times. And again, you're going to copy always what's in the very bottom right box, and that's what you're going to put in your tables in your project. And then again, you're going to make some observations. Okay, so they're just the observations that you're seeing. Try to be as thorough as you can because I want you to be making your own observations. I also wanted you to talk real quick about chapters 9, 10, and 11 projects. Those projects I made links in JetNet. But you can also, I think they're only now links in JetNet. There's no hard copy pages in your course pack. But you're going to need some candies, a sharing size bag or bigger of regular color Skittles, preferably. And then in the M&Ms, you can choose between peanut, almond, peanut butter, and plain M&Ms. If you want to use my candies, let me know and I will send you that link so you can choose the candies that you're using for those projects. Let me know if you have any other questions. Have a great day.